Hello, everybody. Jacob here. Welcome back to the Fashion Bunker. So, there's another broken Chanel bag of the week. However, who made the video? Whose bag broke? And what did they have to say about their broken bag? Well, the bag in question is a Chanel 22 bag. The person in question making a video is not a small content creator. LV Lover CC just dropped a video about her Chanel 22 bag breaking. But it's what she... Hi, LV Lover CC. By the way, go subscribe to this wonderful lady. I shall post the link down below to her YouTube channel. But what this lovely lady had to say is what irked me. And we're gonna talk about it in the most respectful of ways. I shall sustain myself. But first, subscribe to my channel. If you haven't already, push the join button next to the subscription button. Become a member today and gain access to extra perks. You can also join me on Patreon. Super Jacob, all spelled together there as well, for extra perks. Thank you to my members and patrons who have already pledged. This video is being shot live in front of a live virtual audience. I live stream every Saturday and midweek. So, LV Lover CC just dropped a video a couple of minutes ago. Literally, well, maybe an hour ago by now, about her Chanel 22 bag breaking, showing the same strains of use as mine did. Now, I would like to remind you that a year ago, I made a video right after purchasing my Chanel 22 bag from the Métier d'Art collection 2022. It was in a magenta with gold hardware, size medium. Started peeling 20 minutes after I wore it out the first time. And I made a video about this almost a year ago now, right? LV Lover CC bought the black 22 bag in a size small from the first batch of bags, not the Métier d'Art, but the spring summer collection. And so now, so she bought it already back in April or March of 2022, is what she says in her video. By the way, everything I say in my video is for entertainment purposes only. Just alleged, not rooted in any truths or facts. So just to be very clear here, I am paraphrasing also what LV Lover CC says in her video. And this is, and now the fact that she's talking about her bag having issues, by the way, we're going to get to it, to the details. Her bag shows the same type of issues that my bag had a year ago. But it's what she says that irks me. Because as LV Lover CC talks about the bag, before she shows you what happened to her bag, she says something. She says, I'm not the type of person to make a video to, and I'm paraphrasing here, to bash a brand publicly. If I have an issue with the brand, I will try to talk to them personally, privately about this to solve the issue. I try to support the brands online. I'm like, girl, are you paid by Chanel? Because the way you're talking about it sounds mighty awfully a lot like somebody who's paid by a brand, so they're not allowed to voice any criticism. They're not allowed to voice if they're having an issue. So basically you're telling us you've been silent for almost a year about this bag, the 22 bag. You didn't want to share with us what is wrong with your bag because you didn't want to throw shade at Chanel. So by saying what you said, now correct me if I'm wrong, you guys, in the comment section down below, doesn't that kind of imply that LV Lover CC is throwing shade at me and at Romina Rose May? Shout out to Romina, by the way. Link to her channel also down below. Wonderful YouTuber and friend of mine, because we both made videos on our breaking Chanel 22 bags last year. And quite a few people threw shade at us for sharing this information, saying like, oh, you're brand bashers. I'm like, I spent $5,000+ on this freaking bag. And it started peeling 20 minutes after wearing it the first and only time. And you're throwing shade at us, at Romina and myself, for divulging this information. Now, since last year, More and more videos have been popping up on YouTube and other social media platforms where people are discussing the issues that they're having with their 22 bags, with their Chanel 22 bag. So you might have thought at the beginning when Romina and myself were throwing the alarm, you might have thought, oh, they're just clout chasing. They might be lying. The bags might be fake and this and that. No, the bags were very authentic and the money we spent on those bags, very authentic. But now, after a year has passed and after so many other people have had similar or same issues as us and made videos about it, now you're starting to believe us. Interesting. And yet I still have an issue with LV Lover CC, a lady who has 200,000 subscribers on her YouTube channel and behaves like, oh, I'm not the type of person to throw shade at these brands, but I'm going to make this video now as well. As you have maybe noticed, I have not been using my Chanel 22 bag in the size small black for a while now, she continues in her video and says, this is because the bag has a lot of issues. And I don't know how these issues, you know, could have happened. Then she mentions another YouTuber that she talked to that shared with her the issues with the bag. And I'm like, literally, Romina and I have spoken about this a year ago. Oh, wait, I see. I'm a smaller YouTube channel and you don't know of my existence. Who am I to say to you guys now? Like, you know what I mean? You're going to come for me now in the comments and you're going to say, who do you think you are? You know, you don't have the reach that this lady has. You don't have so many subscribers. She doesn't even know who you are, nor does she care who you are. It's true that she does not mention me even once in her video, but guess what, you guys? LV Lover CC tagged me in her video 1 month ago, and the video in which she tagged me in to do a tag was the 5 best bags for everyday life. This was more or less 1 month ago. She made the video, tagged me in the video. She didn't mention my name in the video, but she tagged me in the description box, like saying like, hey, these are the people I tagged to also do this tag. So she knows who I am. Okay. So there's two options here. Either she's one of those people that goes on into this click of somehow gatekeeping the situation and saying like, you know what? Bags are only for girls, not for boys. So I'm not going to, you know, talk about any guys wearing this bag, just girls. Huh. But then you also choose not to mention Romina, who also made a very, very specific video about that. She's a girl. I can assure you she's a girl. She's not a boy. So anyway, and this might be an issue that has to deal with that. Or what else could be the issue? You know that I exist. You tagged me in your video, but now you're behaving like you never heard about this issue. But I digress, and we'll get back to this in a second. LV Lover CC goes on to talk about what the issues are of her bag. Let me show you. Maybe I have the next picture. So this is the bag we're talking about, the 22 bag in a size small. When she contacted her sales associate to tell the sales associate, hey, look at the issues I'm having with the bag. And let me also show you what issues. Look at that. The same exact issues my bag had, right where the chain pulls. All of that upper coat, upper layer just peels off. Now, LV Lover CC said that she wore this bag 5-6 times. She used it really not very often. And when she and here's the kicker, when she contacted her sales associate to let the sales associate know of this issue, and mind you, she's a big client at Chanel. She buys a lot at Chanel. She also buys a lot at Louis Vuitton. She buys a lot at Hermès, at Dior. So you know what I mean? The lady has a budget. It's not like she bought one bag in her life and then she comes back to Chanel and then Chanel treats her like, okay, girl, you bought one bag with us. What do you want? No, she is a return customer. She's treated with the highest respect at Chanel. They had the audacity to tell her, we've never had an issue like this before. This is what she's telling us. We've never seen anybody come to us with an issue like this. This is the photo that she took. You see, it's her nails. This is a screenshot from LV Lover CC's video. Look at that. Same issue that I had with my bag a year ago. And so the sales associates, apparently she spoke to several, told her, we've never had anybody complain. And I don't know if you're gatekeeping or not gatekeeping because you don't want your viewers to know about certain other content creators or not. I don't know what the, I don't know. Okay. I'm giving you the benefit of the doubt. Maybe you really have no clue that Romina and myself made videos about this bag and these issues a year ago. But then you also mentioned you were talking to Amy or Kat and Amy, both of them. They know the issues that I have. They've mentioned it on their channel. And I'm just saying this why. I'm saying this because if your sales associate came to you and had the audacity to tell you that they have never heard of this issue happening before, well, the least you could have done was to say, no, not true. This is an issue that Chanel is aware of because Dacob, for example, and Romina, a year ago, went back to Chanel because of this exact issue and mentioned to Chanel that they have this exact issue. Chanel took my bag back immediately and refunded me my entire sum of money. Romina had a little bit less luck, so Chanel is aware of this. So for them to tell you that they're not even aware of the situation and for you to not tell them, this is an issue that we have receipts thanks to these other content creators from the luxury YouTube community that have made videos on this exact topic, on this exact problem over a year ago. You see, people of YouTube, this is why it's important that people like us make these videos. So instead of coming for us for raising awareness for this shit happening to their quality control, instead of coming for me for raising awareness about this, you should say thank you, Dacob, for raising awareness about this. Because thanks to my video that was made over a year ago, almost a year ago, and thanks to Romina's video, now you have the proof. You can use those videos as receipts when you go to Chanel. And if they have the nerve to tell you, we don't know anything about this, you say, well, maybe you should know about this. Because look, there's proof. These people have made videos about this a year ago. They brought the bags back. It's in your system, Chanel. You know that the bags were either brought back to you, replaced, or even refunded. So I don't want to hear any more bullshit. People coming for me saying, how dare you raise awareness? These videos are testaments and documents that you can use to help you as a consumer to deal with this shit. And this is what irks me. The audacity to come and say, oh, you know, I don't know. I've never heard about it. You know, I'm not the type of YouTuber who's going to raise awareness about these issues. But why, LV Lover CC? Why has it come to a point now? Now you're raising awareness. Why now? I see. 200,000 subscribers. So you got more to risk, right? Than we do, the smaller channels. So we take the hit a year ago. We're the ones who paved the way. Now that you feel it's safe enough to talk about this, because all of us got the shit for talking about this, all of us got all the negative comments thrown our way when we started raising awareness about this bag over a year ago or a year ago, we got all the slack. Now the consumers are more used to this. Okay, now it's fine. Now you're allowed to talk about it too, because people are not going to attack you now because they've attacked us already. I see. Is that what's happening? Because I have a sneaky, mighty suspicion that that's exactly what's happening here. Let me show you some more pictures. There you go. This is, by the way, I wish LV Lover CC all the best. Don't get me wrong here. I wish this lady all the best. I am not coming for her as a person. I am not coming for her as a content creator. I'm just really upset that there's lack of transparency. And especially, you know, this is the moment for us to unite, not to separate. This is the moment when you, in your video, say, by the way, you guys, I'm not the only person who has had this exact issue happening to my bag. This other content creator also had issues. This other one also had issues. The more of us raise awareness about this and the more legit we come across. Instead, I smell this gatekeeping all the time, and it really, you know, it strikes a chord. Oh, I'm good enough to tag me in your tag video so that when you tag me, my viewers get to know about your video. I'm good enough for that. But I'm not good enough to actually say, hey, Jacob actually has the same exact issue that went down with his back. The same exact issue. Let me show you more pictures. Let me show you my bag now. Just, you're like, Jacob, what are you talking about? Corey K in the chat says, oh my God, I saw her video and commented that other YouTubers had the same problem. I was going to reference you and Romina, but didn't know if I was allowed to without your permission. Of course you're allowed to. It's like so obvious. Let me show you now from my other folder, my bag from last year, which I brought back to Chanel. This is after 20 minutes of wear. Look at this, the entire freaking top coat peeled off. This is my finger, my thumb, my bag that I brought back to Chanel from the Métier d'Art 2022 collection. Look at that peeling. Let me show you more. I have close-ups. This is when we started the whole conversation about whether or not Chanel is even leather anymore. Is it full grain leather? Is it bonded leather? This looks like a freaking piece of textile under there. What the hell is this? This made the rounds on social media last year in the luxury YouTube community. We were all talking about it. Don't tell me you don't know. I mean, come on. Like, seriously. Anyway, I showed this to my sales associate, and the second I showed it to her, she's like, oh my God, Jacob, I'm so sorry. Bring it back immediately. Like, I know you just bought the bag from me, like, a couple of days ago. This should not be happening to your bag. Bring it back. This is an exceptional situation. We're going to refund you the entire amount. You know how iffy Chanel is when it comes to refunding anything. They don't want to refund you the money. They can give you a voucher. They're going to try to fix it. And, you know, God knows, when you send it off to repairs with Chanel, good luck. Good luck and shout out to your family, because chances are you're going to see your bag in half a year. Nothing's going to change, which is also what happened to me. I'm speaking from personal experience and other bags that I have issued with from Chanel that were sent off for repairs and then never really got repaired. But I still had to wait half a year to a year. Anyway, let me show you the next picture. You're like, what is this? This could be any bag. What is this pink thing? Let me show you a picture of me. The first day I got my bag, I was so happy. I took this picture with me and the size medium Chanel 22 bag from the Métier d'Art 2022 collection. This is me literally taking the picture the day that I wore the bag, the first and only time. I wore it for this shoot. Then I went to the supermarket, came back home, busted. The bag was busted. All right. Been there, done that, girl. Been there, done that. Instead of, and you know, and LV Lover CC goes on in the video and says, you know, I just want to raise awareness about this, guys. I'm not the type of person to throw shade at these brands. I'm like, what shade? What shade are you throwing? The only shade you're throwing indirectly is towards me, because you're making it sound like I'm the idiot who 1 year ago raised awareness about a broken bag, about their quality flaws. You see what I mean? This is the thing that you're perpetrating. Again, giving you the full benefit of the doubt, because you could have said that without any ill intentions. I totally see how that could have been the case. But you thought, what, a whole year before you made a video about your broken 22 bag, because you're so thoughtful about what you say and how you say it? And yet you didn't think about the repercussions what you're saying might have on other content creators. Because you're better than us. Because you're not the type of person who's going to throw shade at these brands. That's not going to raise awareness about these things. You said very clearly in your video, you talk about these issues you have with these brands directly with the brands. You don't make a video about this. And yet now you feel compelled to make a video about the 22 bag after so many other content creators have made the video, have had all the issues with, you know, people in the chats and the comments attacking them. How dare you speak out against Chanel and blah, blah, blah. But now that we have raised the bar, we have raised our standards from being brainwashed consumers that never dare speak out about issues with these brands. Now that we've raised the bar just that little bit above that literally hole level, that abyss level of like mouth zipped. You're not allowed to say if there's a problem with your bag and quality issues. Now we're allowed to talk about it. And now bigger channels are finally stepping up and also talking about it. But never giving credit to who actually sounded the alarm such a long time ago and took all the slack for sounding the alarm. Yeah, it irks me. I'm sorry. You can come for me as much as you want. You can hate on me now. You could say, oh my God, you're so petty. You're so, you know, annoying, you know, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I am. Because stuff like this, it took you, you know, a year to figure out how to formulate delicately the fact that you have an issue with Chanel with this bag, but you didn't think it through that what you're saying is actually going to throw shade at us again. Not here for it. Thank you, LV Lover CC. Good luck to you. Goodbye.